चांसलर सारंकर उपदेश क्रमे अनुमति क्रमे आम मैंने आरंभ कर सारी से आपण मानू बहुत धन्यवाद एवं समस्त को मोर अनुरोध सब लर्नर मानू टेक्निकल पर्सन मानू से माइकटा को म्यूट करी रखिए रिसर्च पर्सन स्पीच देबे एवं क्लास सरला परे आम मैंने लर्नर मानू 10 मिनिट्स टाइम दबू से माने से मानकर क्वेश्चन पचारि पारिबे सारंक साथ डायरेक्टली भी इंटरप्ट हो पारिबे एवं ता पूर्वरु जो मानकर क्वेरी थिबो से माने चैट बॉक्स रे मध्य तांकर क्वेश्चन टाइप करि पारिबे। मु वेलकम करूची जगन्नाथ सारंकु जे कि आम मानक पई निश्चित भाव रे किछि टाइम देई से लर्नर मानकु एवं आम मानकु उत्साहित करिबे आज मूल्यवान क्लास टी को। थैंक यू, वेलकम जगन्नाथ सर।
थैंक यू सर, वेलकम टू ऑल द लर्नर्स टू दिस क्लास। एक्चुअली व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इन नेटवर्क साइबर सिक्योरिटी, सिक्योरिटी इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट। एवरीवेयर वी नीड सिक्योरिटी जस्ट लाइक अवर प्रॉपर्टीज। The same way we have also used the word security in data. Data is the vital part of the organization. How the organization maintain data in a secure manner so that particular course curriculum framed by OSU is highly essential. So before you are discussing the network security, security word itself is required only for data and the authorized user can access data. And how we can prevent for the unauthorized users, more the mechanism is required for this curriculum. So before you are starting this, what is a network? So basically, network is a connection of one or more computer placed in an environment that is also known as the network. So that security consists of set of policies and practices adapted to prevent and monitor unauthorized access of data. You take the example of antivirus system. When we are using the antivirus system through which we can secure the data. So what is network security? So network security is the protecting of files and directories. File means your similar type of records. We are maintaining office. That office has also different files. That files as well as the directories we are telling in Windows, that is also known as the folder. So how the files and folder is secure? So that the mechanism we are adapting, that is also known as the files and directories in the network of computers against misuse, hacking, and unauthorized access to the system. So middleman should not hack the data. Due to this, that network security concept is required. But another thing is, what is cyber security? Network security basically for the files and the directories, no one can misutilize, no one can hack. But what is cyber security? This is the practice of protecting internet connected systems and networks from digital attack. This is the brief introduction of cyber security and network security. So next you come to the syllabus. As per the syllabus, the network security, there is also the 4 units, network security model and network security threats. Second one is the firewalls. Third one, intrusion detection system and intrusion prevention system, public key infrastructure. This is the thing, that is the module, that is also the block one of network security part. So network security model, it is a network security model. That model has also four layers. One is the physical model, physical layer. Another is a VLAN, that is known as your virtual local area network. And there is also the ACL layer. ACL means that is also the access control list. And another is also the software. And another is the user. And the sixth one is the administrative, IT department. That model, the network model basically had the seven layer model that divides during the task of securing a network infrastructure. Basically, why we are using the computer network? It gives importance that sharing of resources among different users. In a computer, the resource means our hardware, the software, and different network devices, as well as also the user. We all are treated as one resource. And these resources are shareable by using the concept network. And for sharing these resources, it has the network security model consists of seven layers. Now we are discussing very simple way, one by one layer. And why the particular layer is required? What is the physical layer? The physical layer primarily focus is on physical security. The physical security is applied to prevent attackers. Means whenever we are using the network security, the middleman or the hackers may also use data. So from them, how can we prevent? So that is the function of the physical layer. So that physical layer has a security. For this reason, we can say that if this layer, physical layer fail, the physical layer has failed as well as because the attacker would be able to manipulate data as if they had breached the facility. Physical security comes in many forms, including site design, access control devices, alarms, and cameras. You remember, at the time of maintaining the physical layer, it gives importance on the designing part as well as access control. Access control means someone may read, someone may write, and someone may also use both read and write operations. These operations should be protected, and it gives alarm, and or the cameras may also show us who is the person hacking it. And second one is also the VLAN layer. VLAN means virtual local area network. Virtual means not in reality. Now we are taking the classes in computer. Now this is a virtual classroom. Now we people are discussing each other, or you are the learner and we are the counselor. The discussion is going on the learner and the counselor. So whenever you are discussing everything, you remember as if you think that we people are in a classroom. The teacher and the student is a close interaction. So same way here, there is a virtual local area network. So there is a LAN one man, three types of network, local area network, wide area network, and also the metropolitan area network. These network, virtual network. So it is used to segment networks for multiple regions. The primary reason that you make VLAN is to group together common host for security purpose. For example, putting an accounting department on a separate VLAN from the marketing department is a smart decision, because they should not share the same data. This breaks the network up into less secure and more secure. In this context session, we will be discussing the implementation of virtual LAN. So where we can implement the VLAN? The first step in implementing VLAN is to determine public and private network. any external faxing devices should be put on public VLAN. Example of this include web server. So when there is a network, we people must be aware of there is a server and there is a client. We people are treated as one-on-one client. The server is at a remote area. And how we are accessing the server? The server contains all type of information and data. And we, the client, accessing that data. So, at the time of the example of web server, and there is a external FTP, file transfer protocol. Protocol means a set of rules. Set of rules are required before we are, say, protecting the data. So, and the external DNS server. And another thing regarding implementation of VLAN security, to place internal device on private VLAN, which can be broken off into internal user VLANs and internal server VLANs. And the last step is to break down the internal user and the server VLAN by department and grouping respectively. So that the second layer has also the particular purpose for the file transfer server and also the web server. There we are using the VLAN security, the virtual LAN, local area network security. And another, the third layer of network security model is ACL, ACL access control list. So suppose you take one example. The access control list means who is the user, who will use what sort of work. That is known as the access list. Suppose you take X is a person who is hiring a project. That project completed by some experts or professionals. The person who has taken the project, suppose X is the person taking the project, means he has all rights on that project. All rights means he may can create, he may can also read, write, delete, copy, move. All the file operations are provided to the particular user because he is the main person who has taken the software. That is also the one group. And the second group for completion of the particular project, some persons, X person also hired some persons. They are also the another access list. But some limited operations allowed on that project. What limited? Suppose you think it, they may read the file, they may create the file, and they may also write the data on the file, and they may also save the file. Example, some of the minimum operations are provided. They are also the another list. For the rest of the category, only the execute operation is allowed. So different files are also usable by different persons. So that is also the one type of security, and different users can also use it by using password mechanism. In the simple way, we can also protect the files, just like we are three persons. Actually, the persons hired the file, he is the main user. All type of persons are given to that file. And the three persons are hired for completion of the project. They are allowed some operations. They are also the another access list. And the last list is the, they have no more option, only execute, means they are getting the output of the file. This way, we can also using it. So that is also the access control list. So that access control list are written on both routers and firewalls. So how we can protect that access list? With the help of firewalls. Access lists are created to allow and deny access between a host and different networks, usually between VLANs. So this makes them absolutely indispensable in the area of network security. Now come to the implementation of ACL security. The important part to creating strong ACL is to focus on both inbound ACL as well as outbound. Small companies can get by with creating very few ACL, such as allowing inbound traffic on port 8 and 443 HTTP, hypertext transfer protocol, and HTTPS servers. So this is the way we can also implementing ACL security. And the fourth layer of network security model is the what is the software layer. So basically we are using computer for two sides. One is the software, another is the hardware. Software is the ready-made programs. That programs is developed by someone. As long as we are keeping that software for our purpose, that is a customized software. Whenever you are sending that software to the outsiders or to the others, that is also known as the ready-made software, and that is a packaged software. So that software concept, basically it is a ready-made program, someone has prepared it and we are getting the output of that particular program. So that is known as the software. So what is the software layer? It is a focus on keeping software up to date with upgrades and patches in order to mitigate software vulnerabilities. Remember, so what are the problems that comes to the software that must be rectified time to time. So whenever that software must be rectified from time to time, understand, the person who has developed the software, he has all rights. What type of security mechanisms are used so that one cannot also access the source code. Now the source code is also available in computer, that is the open source system. But once we are using that source code, if you have that idea how to develop the software, you can learn it. But the person who has developed the software, he or she can also develop it, and that can be implemented for someone organization, means the user cannot open the software. So for that purpose, the security mechanism is also required. How that can be implemented? Each layer has its implementation part. Implementing software security includes applying the most current patches and upgrades, so that this reduces the amount of exploits and vulnerabilities on a specific host and application. Remember, once you have developed the software that can be implemented and any modification is required, that modification part is also under the developer. That is not given to us. And the fifth layer is the what is the user layer. Basically, we are also the user. And in a database term, we are treated as the end user. Without knowing the background details of the software, getting the output. For example, MS Word we are using. We are the end user. In a database concept, we are the user. User means without knowing the background details of the software we people are using and getting the output. That's why we are treated as the user. So the user layer focus on the user's training and knowledge of security on the network. Suppose you are the user. So whenever you are the user, you want to use your software. Suppose you write a program. Suppose you are creating a document. How the document should be secure? So before you want to protecting the document, simple way, we are putting the password. And another thing, if you are using the password, for each file there is a need of the password. You think that each day number of files we people are created. If you are putting one password in each file, you remember how many number of files were created, how many number of passwords we are given to the file. Means we must maintain a record. To avoid this problem, we are maintaining the folder for different activities or different purposes. We are maintaining the different folders for your accounting folder, office work folder, and your sending of letters, diary dispatch records. For different records, for different folders, we are putting simple password. That is also the user level, that user can also maintaining that particular security. And that 60 layer of network, that is the administrative level. So there is a database administrator, there is a network administrator. How the data will be controlled, how different users will use the data, who the user will do what sort of work, that is provided by the database administrator. Database administrator and another is the network administrator. Whenever we are telling the database administrator, that is the internal FIR. Different files are sharing to different computers. Suppose you are 100 users. Who is the user, do what sort of work, that is alerted by the database administrator. And whenever database administrator is allocated different type of activities towards, accordingly we people are using this. No one cannot use this. Suppose file one is used by user one, means that user has the right to open that file, and what are the task handle, that is also allowed. Means that user can read that file and write that file and save that file or print that file or execute that file, simply you can say. You cannot also delete that file. That type of security mechanism provided by the network database administrator. And another part is the network administrator. Whenever you are telling the network administrator, when there is a client and there is a server, there is a network administrator means you think that there must be a server, there must be a client. Client itself is a one-one computer, server itself is a high capacity computer, which can control a number of users. So that whenever they are using, there is a client-server technology. In industry, what is happening, we are using the computer means there is a client-server technology, network area. There is a client-server technology. If that system, that server can control to number of users, and that is depending on the operating system. Whenever you are purchasing the operating system, the vendor is asking for how many users you need that system. Suppose we are telling we need 100 users. So whenever that operating system has 100 users, means that server can also control to 100 users only. And each user must be identified by the password. That is also the, if that system may be a server, if the system may be a client, that can be done by only the software. And that client system is also the minimum configuration, and that is a higher configuration. The server is the higher configuration. If it is the higher configuration, you think that the internal components or the memory, the processor or hard disk, all these things should be the capacity of each and every component is a higher side. So how one user will connect to another user, and how the server will, the client is send the request, server solve the request, means the client put their problem, the server solve their problem. If that thing is not controlled there, means the network administrator had the right or look after all these things, means with the user cannot do all these things, that is done by the network administrator. So that the administrative layer focus on the training of administrative user. Remember, at the time of developing a software, there is a maintenance of the software. There is a user manual and there is a maintenance. So whenever the minor maintenance required to the software, how the user will do it instead of calling to the developer. Each and every time, the software developer may not be available, or the software developer may not have time to come and rectify the problem. So that the minimum training is required to the user regarding the software. If a minor problem arises to the software, we the user can also easily rectify that software. Same way, like the software, you come to the hardware part. If a network administrator also assign minor maintenance work to different users, they can also solve their problem if the fault arises. Maybe the minor fault or maybe the major fault. Accordingly, that particular administrative layer shows to us, means it gives importance or it focus on the training of administrative users. Some of the users may be administrative users who may support. We are telling simply the supporting hand. The network administrator may not do all sorts of work, and that work must be distributed among the staffs. Some staffs will cooperate, some staffs will do the task, so that training is required. The administrator includes all members of management. It is much like the user layer, except dealing with a higher level of secure data on the network. So remember, the most part of all these things is how to secure data. That particular part is always into different layers. And the last layer is known as the IT department layer. IT means Information Technology Department. But each layer has its implementation. You go through the details also, you may get it. Very in a nutshell, we people are also discussing, or briefly we people are discussing regarding each layer, so that the last layer is also the IT department layer. IT means Information Technology Department layer. It consists of all the network security professionals. So all the network security professional means who are the user of the particular data, and who are the person they are controlling the data. All are involved, maybe the server side, maybe the client side. Just like who is the user doing some sort of work, and who is the administrative layer part, they are also all are involved into the IT department layer. That particular, these are all of the people that make a network operational and maintain the network, and all of the hosts that reside on the network. The IT department layer is like the administrative layer, except the IT department has accounts to access any device on the network. For example, you take the IT department user can have a read, write, and modify access to a database table structure. So here comes to the one part, the database. Basically, the IT department had the right. They can do, before that people are discussed, different users have right to access the data of the database. That operations or the access may be read, write, and modify access. So that particular database is controlled by the database administrator. And whenever that database administrator is controlled the data, who the user will do what sorts of work, that is also the duty of the all the IT department staffs. And the implementation of IT department staff, basically, each person of the IT department layer should have some type of background in network security. Means the background knowledge of the security must be IT department set. Means we people must be well trained before we are coming into the IT department staff. So this is the way all the seven layers briefly people are discussed, or you have the idea regarding this. If you have a doubt, you may ask after completion of this session. Thank you. Next, you come to the working with the network security model. So that working with the network security model, you come to the working with network security model. Shortly, you are telling is known as the NSM. So how the network security model is also functioning? This will cover the layout of the network security model, as well as how attacks against a network can be profiled with the use of the model. So we will look at how to implement the network security model on a new network, so that how the network security model can be used to mitigate an attack. So attackers is always on the data. So whenever we are sending data one part to the another part, the middleman is always securing. So remember one thing in banking transactions. So before the money is debited from the customer's account to the other's account, at the time of monetary transaction, for the security purpose, the bank has given the OTP, one-time password. So why? That is also the one type of security. That security must be required for the purpose sake of the customer. Means the money should not directly transfer from the customer's account to the businessman's account. That is a one type of security. The minimum security is maintained by the bank, how the customer's amount will be safe. That is a security. Attackers is always behind us. That is a one type of job. The mischievous activities comes to the network. Middleman is always hacking. So that the security is always required. More and more research activities are going on how to secure data. Data is the vital part of the organization. We people are very much aware of regarding the organization data. Not the software, not the computer system. Only the data is the vital part. It is the important part. It is the higher side of the organization. It must be secure so that these are the security mechanisms required in different ways. And how the network security model can be used to mitigate an attack. Security model can be used to mitigate an attack that has already happened. The attack is directed at the software layer. So in the software layer, basically the network security model is used to reduce less of the attack in which layer of the particular work, means the software. Software is the prime factor than the hardware, remember. No doubt both hardware and software are also highly important, both are also correlated. But if we given the priority, software the high priority. Why? Without software, hardware cannot also run. Means the hardware components come to the running stage with the help of the software. So that we are telling software is the important than the hardware. And both are correlated. So that particular network security model is also basically given importance to the software layer. This layer that has been compromised. We will need to go through the layer from the top to the bottom of mitigate. So how we can mitigate that particular problem? There is a initial mitigation, long-term mitigation. That network security model for mitigating that attack means there is a initial mitigation and then the long-term mitigation. So that particular initial mitigation, we will mitigate these hosts, the same as the original host, each host that is possibly compromised should be isolated from the network and scanned for possible malware. So there is a hardware, there is a software, there is a malware. Malware means that is also your problems comes to the software. Means the virus. Malware means it is a virus, you think that. That virus should not attack and that problem should not come to the software. So that there is a initial mitigation, host to host. And a long-term mitigation means for the short time, we can also do the initial mitigation and the long-term mitigation. So in the software layer was actually layer which failed. We will start by looking into this layer. We should attempt to push out the updates in order to mitigate this type of attack from happening again. We should make sure all machines are updated with the most current patches. Means the system should be updated. Means in a computer, we are telling the software there is an updated version. Through the updated version, the software must be updated. Virus cleaner software must be updated. So that if these are the updated version in our software, means we can mitigate in a long run time. If the attacker or the misuser misuse the software, that can be also solved. And another, there is a introduction to network security threat. Threat is always a problem. Threat means there is a problem. We are always afraid of network security threat. Threat is always there. We are always afraid of to the what? Hackers. We are always afraid of to the hackers. So that security threat defined as a risk that which can potentially harm computer. The computer system should not harm. So data is the main part of the organization. It must secure. So that how the data should be secure, sometimes different type of virus may also come to the computer. There is a Trojan horse, and there is also the those denial of service. The attacks are usually utilized malevolently to destroy and consume a given network resource. Remember, once virus attack to the system or to the software, what is the major problem? It attack. Attack means what is it? It is not the biological virus. It is a software. Virus is a software. Its task is to destroy data. Means whenever you are using the computer, our data is occupied and the software is also occupied. And some of the executable files are into the software. The virus basically attack to the executable files. Once the virus attack to the system, means your speed up the processing speed of the computer is automatically less. Means these virus means that software will occupy to the memory. So that we are not very speedily, we cannot execute our data. That is the main problem. So there is also the virus cleaner software. That through the virus cleaner software, we are also cleaning that particular system. So there is a auto activation of this software, and that software must be always up to date. Up to date means that particular version must be up to date, so that the system must secure. So that system should always secure that particular system at the time. So network security threats. Network security threats are also two categories. One is the passive threats, another is the active threats. Passive threats are sometimes referred to as evasive dropping, involve attempts by attacker to obtain information relating to communication. At the time of communicating one system to another system, some hackers may also hacking the data. That is the threat, and that type of threat is known as the passive threat. And that passive threat, that has also the 2 points: release of message contents, traffic analysis. And there is the active threats. That active threats means masqueaders, replay, modification of message contents, denial of service. That is also the passive threats. So release of massive contents, a telephone conversation, an email message, and a transferred file may contain sensitive or confidential information. So whenever we are sending message through email, or you think it, you are transferring a file from one system to another system, that means there is a passive threat. That file may be used by someone. So that particular file may be utilized by others. How that security mechanism is also required? That is the threat. That threat should not come to the mind of the user. Means someone may also steal the data of the file. So that release of message contents means, that means you are sending the email message and we are transferring the file from one system to another system. We would like to prevent the opponent from learning the content of the transmission. Means at the time of transmitting data from one system to another system, third person could not also see it, and any person cannot also see it. Only the person to whom you are contacting, they may also use it. That is also the further purpose. For the sake of the data, there is a need of the security. And that problem comes to the mind of the user is known as the threat. So another point regarding the passive threat is the traffic analysis. It is a kind of attack done on encrypted message, that is encryption and decryption technique. While you are sending a block of data, group of data, one system to another system, one area to another area, data must be encrypted. Encrypted means there is a data encryption standard. Internationally, we are maintaining a standard. Just like as per the height of the person, what should be the weight? That is the standard health. So same way, whenever you are sending data one part of the area to the another part, or one locality to another locality, or one site to another site, at the time of sending the data, that means the traffic analysis gives importance on the encrypted message. Suppose you take, you want to send ABC, that we are not directly sending ABC. For A, we are sending one. For B, we are sending two. For C, we are sending three. Whenever 1, 2, 3 is also sending, that should be decrypted there. Encrypted, we are encrypting the data. And whenever the user, the receiver is receiving data, when the sender is sending data, they are maintaining the encryption standard. And they are also opening that file, means that never readable, that need a secret key. That secret key known as the decryption. Encryption technique, decryption technique. And internationally, one data encryption standard technique is maintaining. So the message must be encrypted, means you are not directly sending the message. It must be encrypted, means it must be another form. For example, before that, we are discussed. And another point, the opponent might be able to observe the pattern of such encrypted data. No one should also observe it. Just like while you are withdrawing money, that ATM counter, there is a message. The outsider should not enter it. If a user is using the ATM machine, second one should not also go through this ATM counter. Why? What type of secret code we people are typing? Someone should not also observe it. It may be a hacked. And another, the opponent could determine the location and identity of a communicating host and could observe the frequency and the length of message being exchanged. Means the opponent, means other person, should not also observe our activities, what way we are encrypting and how that we also send to the receiver part. Now the active threat, it involves a modification of the data stream or the creation of the false stream. The active threat, passive threat, gives importance on the release of message content, traffic analysis, and the active threat involves some modification of the data. Data must be modified. Modified means some changes. What changes are also required? That is done into the active threats. And that threats, we people also solved with a different type of security mechanism. Just like in passive threat, there is a release of message. We follow the, and we follow also email and also the transferring. There is also the some of the techniques we people will follow. And there is a traffic analysis. There is an encrypted message. We can do it so that there is a no threat, and another is the active threat. Active threat is masquerade. It takes place when one entity pretends to be a different entity. A masqueraded attack usually include one of the other form of active attack. So there is also the replay. It involves the passive capture of data unit and its subsequent retransmission to produce an unauthorized effect. And there is a modification of message. It means that some position of a message is alerted, or that message are delayed or rendered to produce an unauthorized effect. If some delay is there, means there may be a chance we people are think someone may also hack it, someone may also modify our data. That should not also come to the data. How it should be secure? There is a denial of service. A denial of service attack takes place when the availability to a resource is intentionally blocked or degraded by an attacker. So basically, we are using that computer network and sharing of resources among concurrent users. It means minimum number of resources utilized by maximum number of users. That is the main advantage of the network. So that particular resource may be a printer, a resource may be a plotter, resource may be any device. That resource should not be blocked. If it may be blocked, we cannot also get the output of that particular device. And another denial of service, in this way, the normal use or management of communication facilities is inhibited. Means there is at the time of communicating one system to another system, one user to another user, that user or both user are communicating, means there is a denial of service, means what data you are sending, that may not be also reached to the destination, that should not also come. And another part, this attack may have a specific target. For example, entity may suppress all message directed to a particular destination. There is an entity. Entity itself is nothing but a user. It is also the database term. Understand? We all are treated as one on entity. Entity means it has some properties or attributes or characteristics. Each one is a one-on-one entity. Entity means itself is a user. It is a database related word. The attack may have a specific target. Example, an entity may suppress all messages directed to a particular destination. That should not be there. That is another type of denial of service. Another form of service denial is the disruption of entire network, either by disabling the network or by overloading it with message so as to degrade performance. What is the main goal? Security threat involves three goals. What are the goals of the security? There is a confidentiality, integrity, and availability. That is the main. Why that the goal of the threat? The main goal of the threat means data should be integrity of the data. So integrity, data integrity means we are given some mechanism. That through that mechanism, data must be secured. For example, you remember, we are given, there is a term, if you have a little bit idea regarding it, you see there is a primary key. Suppose you are creating a database and we are telling that the roll number of the, we are creating a student database, that integrate what I am telling, data integrity, just like the national integrity, national integrity. National integrity means there is also what? Different beings, different also your military beings. There is a army, naval, air force, and for the civilian, there is also the law order, the police people, the military forces, all are working. So their working means we people are secure. That is known as the national integrity. The nation is secure. Means all these beings are performing their duties properly. So we the civilians are also have the security for the sake of the nation. Same way, data integrity. There is a part data integrity. Data integrity is the main part. Data is, suppose you take one example, you are creating a student database. You tell the roll number of the student must be unique. It should not be duplicate. At the time of input data to the database into the roll number, someone may also put it roll number one, and second time we may put it also the roll number. That should not be done. So how should not be done? The minimum security mechanism we can provide, that is also the unique key, or you can tell there is a primary key, that is also the one type of the integrity. So security threat involves three goals. There are main three goals or three aims and objectives of the security threat involved. Confidentiality, the goal, this goal depends how we keep our data private from Avast drafting. Packet capturing and replaying are the example threats for this goal. Data encryption is used to achieve this goal. So that confidentiality means, you see in examination section, there is a word confidential section, means outsiders. Now those are the employees of that particular being. Basically in also the colleges and schools, there is a confidential section, means the examination people are allowed to there. They can do all sorts of, same way, the confidentiality should be there. Confidential means the second one should not be unknown. What data we are sending and what technique we are using for sending it, and it gives priority to the encryption. Data encryption is used to achieve this goal. The confidentiality goal is basically gives importance onto the encryption technique. Encryption means the original data we are not sending, we can put into the another one. Just like suppose you want to send ABC, instead of A you can put 1, instead of B you can put 2, instead of C you can put 3. That is known as the your confidentiality. That gives importance on the word encryption. And another is the integrity. That integrity, I simply told to you, there is in database, there is your data integrity. Integrity means, that means data at the time of input data, we cannot also input wrong data. No doubt, instead, suppose you tell the roll number or the registration of the student should be started in an order. Means 1, 2, 3, 4 like this. At the time of input, we may do some mistake. That mistake should not be done. Once you input 1 means second time you never input 1. If second time input 1 means that is a duplicacy. To avoid that duplicacy, we can put there is a word in database related term that is known as the primary key, or sometimes you are telling there is a unique key. That technique, that is a one type of your integrity of data, that is a practical application in database. Here, that integrity means this goal defines how we avoid our data from being altered, means at the time of changing, understand, no one also should change it. So there is what MI term, man in the middle attack. You always, we are discussed the third person, middleman is always hacking the data. So no third person, the middleman should not hacking data. There is a need of the security. So that research is going on. Day to day, different type of seminars, orientation programs, workshops regarding the security mechanism is always going on. So that country is always need more and more security, just like for the civilians, the security. Now you see the corona is also going on, the corona. So now the police people is also alert. So that because for the security of the public, the law and order department is always active. That is you think, that is our social life, that is our as a private. So how that law and order is actually doing their duties, we must cooperate to them so that we people are also secure or the safe. For the safetiness of the public, the law and order also implementing their rules. So like this, there is also the integrity of the data, and data is the vital part. It must be secure and the availability. This goal defines how we keep available data to our genuine users. Means suppose we are sending, you are the user, user 1, you want to send data to the user number 10. Or suppose you are working at also your Berhampur, you want to send data to the Bhubaneswar office, there is a user. Means what data you are sending, that must be available there. That should not be duplicate, that should not be also wrong interpretation. What you send, that must also reach there. Means in between that two, there is a third person who is intentionally corrupting the data, who is intentionally sending the malicious data or the wrong data, so that may mislead it to the organization. It should not be done. Now, there is a types of network security threat. How many types of network security threats? There is a virus and worms, Trojan horse, SPM, spam, and another is the packet sniffers, maliciously coded websites, password attack. Means if we are maintaining low quality password, that must be also hacked. So that there is a standard password mechanism must be maintained, just like while you are doing the transaction, monetary transaction, each day we people must change our password because someone may hack it or someone may be known to your password. We must change all these things. So another is the zombie computer botnets. So these are the different types, and then the types of network security attack. What type of attack may come to the network? There is a passive attack and active attack, and that passive attack and active attack we are also discussed by using also different type of technique, what you can do it, we are already discussed. And there is a distributed attack, insider attack, and a reconnaissance attack. So passive and active attack is already over. Now you come to the distributed attack. In this attack, an adversary hides a malicious code in trusted software. So at the time of creating a software, you see, while we are using the internet, we are accessing data through internet, you see nothing virus in your computer. After a particular point, you see the virus automatically attack to the computer. Means whenever the crazy comes, or while we are interested to go through the subject, at a particular point, the virus may attack to our software. So it may attack to the software, means that system may be corrupted. System may be corrupted, means the computer is not corrupted, the software may be corrupted. If software may be corrupted, this is a problem. So that by default, there is a antivirus software we are always installed, because we are the learner, we are the user, we must have a crazy, we are interested to go through more and more, but at a particular point, the virus may be there. If you are click it, means that virus attack. If it is attack, it automatically cleaned. So virus cleaner is a software, and a virus developer is a software. That is a business purpose. Both are also creating the virus they are sending, and after sometimes they are sending the virus cleaner, we purchase it and we are cleaning it. By default, there is a virus cleaner, so there is a distributed attack. This software is distributed to many other users through the internet without their knowledge. So like this, what we people are discussed, without our knowledge, whenever we are go through the software through internet, at the time of accessing data, at a particular time, you see the virus automatically comes. If you don't have your antivirus software, that virus may attack. Again, you purchase the antivirus software, or maybe also your license software. That software is also active, so your system will be error free and work will be fine, and you do not face any problem at the time of your work. That is also the one type of security measure. By default, we all the users are using into our computer system. And there is a insider attack. According to the survey, more than 70% attacks are insider. 70% insider attacker. Insider attacks are divided into two categories, intentionally and accidentally. In intentional attack, an attacker intentionally damages network infrastructure or data. Network infrastructure means what are the devices we are using, the network components. Different type of components we are used for the network for sharing the data. That is also known as your initially intentional attack. The attacker intentionally damage network infrastructure or data. Usually intentional attack are done by disgruntled or frustrated employees for money or revenge. So there is a rivalry. While you are working into the organization, there is a rivalry. Means if you are doing very standard way, or your work is also perfect, means some rival person, that is the quality of the person, they may also have that aggressive. If they may aggressive, they may attack such type of, they may disturb such type of activities. That is known as the intentional attack. Now you come to the accidental attack. Damages are done by the carelessness or lack of knowledge. Means without our knowledge, we are doing some of the disturbance to the data. That is also known as our accidental attack. Now there is also the phishing attack, hijack attack, soup attack, buffer overflow attack. So basically, buffer is the temporary memory. In primary memory, some of the terms we people are discussing, not all these things, but some of the highlighted terms we people are discussing. Buffer word means it is a temporary. In primary memory, they see there is a multi-user multitasking. Now you see, we are using in Windows. You see one application we are creating or opening, and without closing, again we are opening another application. And if you double click on another application, then it is also showing to you. It is not closed, it is already into the memory. Means there is a multi-buffering system into the computer. If there is a multi-buffering system, we can do multiple jobs at a time. See, listen, now we are typing the document, we are printing the document, the previous document you are sharing, and at the same time we are using the multimedia kit for our listening up songs, or for to hear, or to also getting some of the to relax the boringness, we are using the multimedia. You see, all these devices are at a time also busy, so that there is a multi buffering system. Means small temporary memories are created into the primary memory, that is RAM, and these memories are occupied with data, so that instead of closing the application, we are also getting the output once we are double click on this particular icon. That is known as the buffer. Buffer is a temporary memory. No doubt RAM is a primary memory or temporary memory. Still, there is a small areas are created while you are doing multitasking work. More than one task at a time we are handling. There is a multi-buffering system into that particular system, so that the user is doing more and more tasks at a time. So that buffer overflow attack. This attack path is the denial of service technique. In this attack, an adversary sends more data to an application than its buffer size. There is a buffer, small areas are created, it has its limited size. If that particular size may be also occupied by the particular another data, how we people also processing our data? So there is a problem. That is another type of attack. It results in failure of a service. This attack is usually used to halt a service or the server. Means the main system, the main computer is also halt if that particular buffer size may be full. Suppose that server is also controlling number of 10 users. For the 10 users, there is a memory. Small area for one user is created. If that particular area is filled by other jobs of the attackers, so there is a problem to the client to access data, or the client should not do. So there is a password attack. We people are discussing password, means there must be a standard password. Instead of maintaining the very small size of a password, we can maintain the standard size password, just like we are creating the mail, or we are also creating, or we are also sending the data. There is a need of the password. Password must be, you see, there is alphabet keys, there is also the special keys, and there are also number keys. These combination you put it so that we can also send the data, that much secure. So most of the times you are listening, do not put your data, but your name be a password, or qualification may be password. Why? These things are already into our mail, or these things may be available into the internet, each person. So that we should not also use this thing. We may maintain a standard password technique so that no one cannot hack it. Each day we must also send it a password, basically where there is a monetary transaction. The organizations, those are sending sensitive data to one organization, to another organization, and to their main office, to the branch office, or branch office to the main office. They must maintain standard encryption technique for this type of problem, to solve this type of problem. And there is a packet capturing attack. So while you are sending data through network, at a time bulk data you cannot send it. Data must be separated in different packets. Just like the companies or the organization, they are sending their items and the goods to the dealers. They are sending their items to small packets instead of big in size. If that packet is big in size, you see, the transportation problem, means the loading and unloading is a problem. Just like small packets are easily portable for loading and unloading, same way, suppose you want to send bulk of data in a network, the network layer is also providing these facilities. It means all the users' data should be divided into small packets. These packets are also sent one by one. Maybe the first one may not be sent it, second one may be also send it. And how many packets our data is also divided, which packet is also reached to the destination or to the receiver, that acknowledgement comes to you. So accordingly, we are known how much data they are getting or not. Then we are also again send the rest part of the data. Data never directly sent to the network. We people are very commonly known data are sending one part of the organization to the another organization. At the time of sending, that data must be divided into small packets. So now ping sweep attack. And there is also the DNS query attack. MITM attack, variety of attack we people are known, and each one have their problems. And to avoid these problems, we people follow also that particular security mechanisms. Next, there is a firewall. So a firewall is a network security system that monitors and controls the incoming and outgoing network traffic based on predetermined security rules. So whenever data we are sending, it must also, there is a file transfer protocol. So some protocols are there, set up rules. So whenever set up rules are followed, there is a, at the time of network security, by default, there is a firewall. Firewall can control that security mechanism. So there's a next thing. Now you come to the different types of firewalls. Network layer or packet filters. There is the application layer and proxies. So remember, network layer or packet filter. Network layer firewalls are called packet filters. We are discussed regarding the packet at the time of setting the ISO OSI model is there. TCP/IP model is there in network. There is a ISO, International Standard Organization, Open System Interconnection, OSI model, TCP/IP model, Transmission Control Protocol, Oblique Internet Protocol. And that OSI model has 7 layers. And TCP/IP has 5 layers. And that 2 layers of OSI is already into the TCP/IP. So whenever that TCP/IP word is here, so in a network layer or packet filters, network layer firewalls are called packet filters. They operate at comparatively low level of the TCP/IP protocol attack stack. TCP/IP transmission control protocol, oblique internet protocol. One protocol must be followed, and that protocol have 5 layers. Through these 5 layers, data is also comes to the user. So there is a word packet. At the time of that layer, different 5 layers are there. That each layer has also different functions, and that one layer is there, that layer is doing that work, that is the packet. So which does not allow packet to pass through the firewall unless they match the established rule set. Suppose you think it, the organizations, they are sending their packets, they are telling one packet means, suppose, 5 items. If there is a 5 items, the particular section is also given the tick mark, each packet have 5 items. 5 items means there is a specific weightage. Same way, whenever suppose you are sending 2 GB data, these 2 GB data is also divided into small packets. And each packet must have also similar size as per the rule of the protocol. The protocol means some of the rules. Basing on the rules, each packet have a specific size. Accordingly, the data is also reached to the destination part. And it first checks whether these packets are equal size or not. If not, that must be actual. That must be checked by the particular network layer, or we are telling there is a packet filters. This firewall administrator may define the rules. Means at the time of sending the packets, the firewall administrator, means the firewall, that software, that administrator is maintaining that firewall is checks, means it is a protective mechanism, that protective mechanism checks each packet have specific size of data or not. If not, that packet is returned back, and that packet must be also similar size. That must be checked, that is the checking purposes. And there is a application layer. The application layer firewall work on the application level of the TCP/IP. With the user always related to the application layer. Different protocols are used. In each protocol, there is also the different layers, just like the network layer. Same way you think there is the application layer. With the user always related to the application layer. We are not related to the any other layer. Our task or for our purposes, that application layer is the required. Application layer firewalls work on the application level of the TCP/IP stack and may intercept all packets which are traveling towards or from an application and they block other packets. The function of application firewalls to determine whether a process should accept any given connection. Application firewalls achieve their function by hooking into socket calls to filter the connections between the application layer and the lower level of the OSI model. OSI means Open System Interconnection. That is also the one type of OSI model and the TCP/IP model. Means these models have also different type of layers, and that either you may send, you follow the OSI model or you follow the TCP/IP model, there is a network layer and the application layer. Both layer have their firewalls, and that firewall administrator is checking all sort of health. There is a proxies, means there is a proxy server. A system may be a server, a system may be a client. That must be done by software. Maybe system is a server, maybe system may be a client. Client server technology running in an organization to sharing their data. The client always sending the request, server solving the request. That technique is also going on into the industry, or where there is a data processing organization, data processing is going on. Each and every organization, they must maintain the client-server technology. Be a client, be a server, that must be done by the software only. Through software, that is recognized. And there is a proxy server. It means running either on dedicated hardware or as a software, as a general purpose machine. You know server and there is a proxy server. What is the function of this proxy server? Maybe a proxy server, maybe a server, that is done by the software. If there is a proxy server, what is its task? It is running either on a dedicated hardware. Means if you are telling a system is a proxy server, there is a specific hardware configuration is required. Means the RAM size is this much, the processor size is the processing this speed, the speed of the processor is this, and the hardware is this. That is also the your dedicated hardware, or as a software and a general purpose machine. There is a special purpose and there is a general purpose. Special purpose means it can do a specific task. General purpose, it solve all sorts of work with the user using that is the general purpose machine. Because number of users are connected to server, so by default, that server is treated as the general purpose machine. That will act as a firewall by responding the input packets in the manner of an application while blocking other packets. A proxy server is a gateway from one network to another for a specific application, and it means it is a gateway. It is a route through which your data is also passed. There is a network address translation. Network address translation means, suppose we are sending that particular data to one source to the destination, that address translation technique is required. Firewalls often have a network address translation. Means it gives basically the firewalls, the role of the firewall in a security purpose basically comes in this unit. You remember. Next, another is that there is a software based firewalls and there is a hardware based firewalls. How the firewall protect the software? How firewall protect the hardware? These are the techniques explained very clearly into the books. You go through the book and as you are finding, and how to prevent your network from anonymous attack. Anonymous. So only you remember, a professional knows where to draw the line and how far she can push the network without breaking it. Be aware of the mythical. Means your network is a secure statement. Means network must be secure. It must come to the particular point that how the network is a secure. So that there is a word, how to prevent your network from anonymous. Anonymous, anyone may also attack to it. How it should be prevent. So these six measures can help in securing cardholder information while allowing a normal network data flow. Never click on a link which was not expected by you to receive. So as long as you are unaware of regarding the link, you never click it. If you click it, some data or some message may also pass from you to the another, means where there is a link or to whom you are linked, your data is also reached there. If your data is reached there, you think that data is also sensitive, there arises some problem. So that as long as you are unaware of a particular link, you cannot also click on the link. If you cannot click on that link, means you see your data is secure or that is also your network part is also the okay. You never that thing. Use different password on different websites. In individual, typically having up to 100 online accounts, the tendency has become to share one or two password across account or use very simple ones such as loved ones' names, pets' names, or favorite sports teams and more common terms. Avoid reusing your main email or account password. Means you remember reusing your main email means the hacker who has cracked or anyhow get entered into your main mail password has the key to your kingdom, because passwords from the other sites you visit can be reset via your main email account. So remember, password technique is also must, but it must be a standard. You never use your date of birth or your name via password. Use updated antivirus and conduct regular scans of your entire system. So we are discussed regarding this. Antivirus must be updated. It must be licensed version. If you are using the internet, if you are using your system, and your system must be secure, and your software must be secure, your data must be in a right manner, means you, it is a good suggestion, you always use your licensed software instead of pirated software. In pirated software means it is okay, but there is not all sorts of technique to prevent the data or to system. Minimum techniques are used, minimum information is there, so that we can also protect it. So that we must use the updated antivirus software, means by default that antivirus software is active and it must also cleanse your virus. By the way, the system is also affected. Limit remote access and make some rules, means remote access control, means sites are different areas and we are into a very remote areas, and sites may be remote area, we are into the another area. While are accessing, that accessing should be limit, it should not be more and more. But another is also the ensure all census data is encrypted using strong encryption algorithm. Remember, we are discussed, there is a standard in data encryption standard. In shortcut, we are telling DES. Data encryption standard is internationally maintained. While you are working into organization, whenever you go through the industry or whenever you do some, whenever you process data and you think your data is vital, at that time we must follow standard data encryption technique to send the data from the source to the destination. From that means one user to another user, one office to another office, or one branch office to the main office, or main office to the branch office. That is also the encryption technique is also required. We are discussed. Maintain a strong firewall for securing your network. This thing we are also discussed. So keep your software updated with the latest update. So if you are using a software for different purposes, means the license software is better. If you are purchasing the license software, all type of facilities also you are getting. Accordingly, you are also, the features are also updated and your problem is also solved. Either you may develop or you may also the user. But if the software should be also required, means that must be licensed, means you must purchase from the company each and every day or each and every in a regular interval. The company is providing different services or different features. That feature comes through this particular software. So that through that software, we can solve our problems, means more and more additional facilities. And there is also some of the techniques and there is also some of the security mechanisms. Directly you can also get it. Just like we are developing software, instead of developing software through Windows, we are developing software through Linux environment. 5 in Linux or that operating system provide more and more security mechanism. But while you are using that particular software, means that must be compatible to Windows, because Windows has no more and more security mechanism. More and more security mechanism is always available to Linux, so that under the Linux environment we are developing the software. But if you are developing, that must be Windows-based compatible, so that each user can easily accessing. Why? It is a graphical user interface. Next, you come to the configuring a firewall into your computer. You must configure, means how to configure a firewall. That is also the step-by-step methods given into the books. You just go through the book. If you are using the firewall, you can also get it. And there is a working of the Windows firewall in Windows 7, Windows 7, Windows 10, and actually Windows 95, Windows 98. These terms are related to the 7, 10, 95, 98, old version, Windows ME, NT. These are the versions of Windows. Version means what were the facilities and what is the latest facilities that comes to this particular software, that is known as the version. So that here it is telling, working with the Windows firewall in Windows 7. Firewall in Windows 7 means what are the security mechanisms firewall in Windows 7. If you have the license software of Windows 7, what are the security mechanisms that is already into that firewall. And configuration in Windows firewall, it has given the step-by-step how to open it and go to the control panel, everything. If you want to install this, means you follow this procedure, then you are getting the output. And these are the practical sites. Sir. Hello, sir.
So, kebe amku pray 12:30 helani.
Haan, sir.
Pilankaro kichi question karchanti mo.
Haan, sir. Then ask the question. Kemti lagila, sir, apna sunile. Sunile kichi.
Haan, moti ke represent karuchi. आपण प्लीज टिके समानंकु डिस्कस करिवारे सहाय्य करिवे
निश्चित करिया सर आपणकर व्यूज कोन थिला सर कोंदु आजर क्लास उपरे ए बुक्स ने आज पाइथला ओके भलो हितंदा
नै बहुत बढ़िया अछि मो सेटा कंक्लूजन ले कहिबि सर
हमें सर कहिबा आउ टिके सजेस्ट करिवे सर दिस इज द फर्स्ट टाइम आई हैव टॉकड इनटू द मीडिया
रियली वेरी नाइस क्लास सर
कहिबि पड़े हला प्रॉब्लम नै बट एक्चुअली व्हाट इज द प्रॉब्लम आपण जेमि आज कहिले मते जे सर ब्लॉग पॉइंट आपर पर्सनल इंटरेक्शन एटा ब्लॉग पॉइंट आज डिस्कस करिया बोली कहले एडा ओटे जस्ट 4 5 डेज आगरु कहिथिले आउटे वेल प्लान्ड हेतदा आ ए टर्म जाक उपरे जस्ट किछि किछि नै थे देखितो आपन को कहबा अनुसार पूरा ब्लॉग टा कंप्लीट हे पालानी सो आई फील लिटिल बिट कोन कहबा आपन एक्सक्यूज मागुछि
आ नेक्स्ट
टाइम डिस्कस
तो आपन को निश्चित मो सहाय्य मागिबी यूनिवर्सिटी पई आपण आमो साथे
आपण हमको एडवाइस करिवे जे आमे कोन करले आउ प्रोग्रेस करि परिबा आ कोट किछि प्रॉब्लम्स होतला काहे कि ए प्रकार वर्तमान जो एक्टिविटीज रे आमे इन्वॉल्व हेले दिस इज द पार्ट
तनु आपण को सारो आउरे दुई तीनटा क्लास नेबी आपण को रिक्वेस्ट करिवी सेटा परे मु टेलीफोनिक डिस्कशन हेबी पिलांकर चारि पांचटा क्वेश्चन अछि से बिषय मु टिके
चर्चा
ओके तो जण पचार चंती how antivirus work
sir antivirus works means that antivirus means that is a software that particular said how it works means listen each software working means there is a executable file and that okay. source code we cannot also see it what way it has written we cannot see you take a simple example suppose we are using a vehicle that vehicle has a kick system and there is a remote system and there is a button system. If you push the button, the vehicle is started. You take the example and that example you implement, that analogy you implement into the software. How it works means whenever it is a research activity, whenever they will go through the software industry, they will read, go through higher and higher side. They may understand just like you press the button, the vehicle is started. How the vehicle is started means the mechanism is already connected. The fuel consumption technique is there. Without kicking on the vehicle, we people are start the vehicle by pushing the button. You see, part of the vehicle is started means there is a mechanism. The mechanism connected same way. At the time of developing the virus software, there is an executable file. Just like we are writing. A student merit list in a program means that logic you are developed through that logic manually we are developed the logic and that logic were implemented to the programming language. That's why you are getting the output of the merit list of the students at the time of enrolled in the colleges. Same way, okay. The virus is also a software that is developed. There is an executable file. That executable file has also the some disturbance programs, disturbance codes. These codes are automatically comes and disturbed. Just like you take it.
Thank you. Sir, next question. How many types of encryption?
Encryption, sir, listen, sir. Encryption is a technique. There is no type C. There is a standard. Suppose our height is 5 feet. Okay. The surgeon or the doctor is telling what should be the weight of the particular person. So someone is seen, suppose your weight is less, means your height is 6 feet, but you are very slim. So at the time of taking the weight, the professor, suppose you feel an uneasy, the professor is telling to give your weight. So give your weight means if the weight is also very less, means that is as per the weight height, there must be standard weight. That is a standard configuration of medical science. Same by international organized, there is a data encryption standard. Internationally, there is a standard. That standard, as per the theory we people are reading, whenever you are working into that organization, how you can send data, that technique they will turn up to you, the developer, or maybe the administrator is also explaining to you how to maintaining that data encryption technique. Just like we are telling, don't put your password, your birthday, date of birth, and your name, your qualification, because that is a simple way one can hack it. So that you can maintain your password into your own style, and that must be jumbled. Same way, that is, there is no types.
Thank you. Sir, next question. Sir, then, why OS means operating system provide Defender?
Why? Defender. So
again.
Defender is a term that all are related to the software also. Operating system is a system software. There is a, what question, sir, again you tell?
Why operating system provide Defender?
Why operating system provide Defender means, listen. Basically, the firewall we are telling into the Windows 7. Windows 7 is an operating system. Microsoft company developed that operating system, Windows 7. The word different, it is working as a defender. Defender means some of the security mechanisms there that can also work in such a way so that no one cannot also misutilize it.
Okay, thank you, sir. Ebang next, pray tinoti question achi one type ra.
To
mu seta koi dauchi pilankar query tike rahuchi ebang pila request bi karuchanti je jemiti amaro network security threats, etc. Emiti, what example deli. The presentation screen, kichi jodi saranko pakre ochi, to tahale babuchi ajitome kori paribani, next class provide kole babuchi, pilamane out to get jani parthante, course visor out to follow idea mili parthanda.
Sir, query back. Con Paria said upon a suggest to current.
Okay, sir. The mu upon such a telephonic kotha hebi, jodi konosi. For example, network security threats ro jemti ame PPT jodi kichi paiba
PPT kichi ame prepare kariya pilangu ta madhyamare ame kichi guidelines dei pariba aa pila kichi taku learner hisabare kemiti briefly taku si analyze kari pari sir pila pai gote main question hoji mu sabale class nala le kue whether you may beginner or you are also the experienced, no problem. While you go through the textbook, you remember on the computer is also very easy science. Some of the technical terms are there, just like a firewall, just like there is a word software, there is a word application software, there is a word systems are like this. Some of the terms, whenever you feel uneasy, you underline it, you come through that book, then you discuss so that your study will be go ahead. This is the process to the learner. And we may also create the slides in our next class, and we may provide information to the students and to the learners.
Nishchita sir, mu nishchita pila manangku, learner manangku, to amane provide kardaba tanko email address re, hala nishchita pila benefit hebe. Last question, sir. Last question is, Mr. Pandav sir pacharchanti, what are the encryption standard number? Each numbers any?
ନାଇଁ ଏନକ୍ରିପସନ୍ ଷ୍ଟାଣ୍ଡାର୍ଡ ସାର୍ ଭେରି ସିମ୍ପଲ୍ ଏକ୍ସାମ୍ପଲ୍ ଟେକ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଇଟ୍ ମଷ୍ଟ ବି ଏ ଷ୍ଟାଣ୍ଡାର୍ଡ ମିନ୍ସ ଲିସନ୍ ସାର୍ ଜଷ୍ଟ ଲାଇକ୍ ସି ସପୋଜ୍ ଆଇ ୱି ଆର୍ ଡିସ୍କସ୍ ରିଗାର୍ଡିଂ ସପୋଜ୍ ୟୁ ୱାଣ୍ଟ ଟୁ ସେଣ୍ଡ ଏ ବି ସି ୟୁ ଆର୍ ୱାର୍କିଂ ଇନ୍ ଏ କମ୍ପାନୀ ଏକ୍ସ କମ୍ପାନୀ ସେଣ୍ଡିଂ ୟୁ ଆର୍ ଦି ଏମ୍ପ୍ଲୟ ଅଫ୍ ଦାଟ୍ କମ୍ପାନୀ ଏକ୍ସ କମ୍ପାନୀ ଇଜ୍ ଅଲ୍ସୋ ସେଣ୍ଡିଂ ଡାଟା ଟୁ ଦି ବ୍ରାଞ୍ଚ ଅଫିସ୍ ଅର୍ ଟୁ ୱାଇ କମ୍ପାନୀ ସୋ ହାଉ ଦି ଡାଟା ବିଲ୍ ଇଜ୍ ସେଣ୍ଡ ଦେୟାର ABC data suppose X company sending by the user one or by the developer. So the developer never send ABC. Developer send some of the modification technique of their terms. Example ABC. Instead of A, suppose you send Z. Instead of B, you send Y. Instead of C, you send X. So whenever that is reached there, they are sending what? The last three characters. And whenever they are decrypting this, ABC is also showing to them. Where you take a simple example. You see there is a lock system into the our luggage, carry bags. There is a lock system, no keys are there, some numbers are there. Understand, suppose you want to send that bag to your brother or to the relatives through the bus. And you are maintaining the encryption standard. You take it. Some of the important components, important items are in your bag. That bag reaches to me, suppose you are sending the bag, carry bag, that carry bag may reach the Jagannath sir. Sir is sending, that comes to the Barampur. But no one can also taking the bag. You see it, some of the mechanisms are there. There is a safe and a secure place into the bus. We are putting it. The bag, no one can also touch it. If they touch it, some alarm comes. Example, there is alarm arises. Or there is some of the camera system. But how myself will open that bag? You are encrypted it. Suppose the number 567 or in a rough and tough manner you are maintaining 903 and there is a 000. But what encryption you are given there, that technique? 903. How I will open it? You are given 903. You tell to me, sir, you just arrange it in 903, then that bag will open and you collect the materials. That is a decryption. You are sending encrypted format, I have decrypted it. But inside it, the data or the materials. The materials is secure by encrypted and what I am getting it, that is a decrypted. You don't put it 1, 2, 3 because someone may also touch it means there is an alarm, you think it. Because that is a secure place of the bus. If some unknown person touch that bag, there is only the conductor will touch it, no alarm. Any person will touch it, there is a alarm. So accordingly, the conductor is handover one by one bag to them. So I will go and telling, sir is sending a bag, he give me. So that he will give to that bag. While you are taking it, then you open it, means there is a decryption. Sending it to the encryption. Our techniques are standard that depends on person to person. Whenever your experience comes and you know the technique, how to send it. And whenever you are the senior and you have some responsibility, at that time, that idea comes to your brain. Or some of the technique they may also telling to you, you put your idea, accordingly you send it, no problem. That is the only practical application part, sir. Any other query, sir, or question?
No, sir, thank you. Ajira learner manankara jati ki query thila, pray ame most probably samasta question ro answer.
Mr. Bhavi,
Ashton Professor, sir, Sahu, sir, briefly discussion kalle. ଏବଂ ସମସ୍ତଙ୍କୁ ପୁଣି ଥରେ ଧନ୍ୟବାଦ ଦଉଛି ଆମକୁ ଏ ଟେକ୍ନୋଲୋଜିରେ ଯେଉଁ ଟେକ୍ନିକାଲ ପର୍ସନ୍ସ ସପୋର୍ଟ କଲେ ଏବଂ ସମସ୍ତ ଲର୍ଣ୍ଣର ଆମ ସହିତ କୋଅପରେଟ୍ କରି ସେମାନେ ପୁରା ଡିସିପ୍ଲିନ୍ ମେଣ୍ଟେନ୍ କରି ପ୍ରୋଗ୍ରାମଟିକୁ ସୁଚାରୁ ରୂପେ ଆମକୁ ଚଳାଇବା ପାଇଁ ସୁଯୋଗ ଦେଲେ ଏବଂ ବହୁତ ସୁନ୍ଦର ଭାବରେ ବ୍ୟୁଟିଫୁଲି ଡେସ୍କ୍ରିପସନ୍ କଲେ ଆମର ପ୍ରଫେସର ସାହୁ ସାର୍ ଯେଉଁଟାକି ମୁଁ ଆଉ ଥରେ ରିପିଟ୍ କରିଦେଉଛି ଲେୟର୍ସ ନେଟୱାର୍କ ମଡେଲ ନେଟୱାର୍କ ସିକ୍ୟୁରିଟି ଥ୍ରେଟ୍ସ ନେଟୱାର୍କ ସିକ୍ୟୁରିଟି ମଡେଲ ନେଟୱାର୍କ ସିକ୍ୟୁରିଟି ଆଟାକ୍ ଟାଇପ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଫାୟାରୱାଲ୍ସ ସଫ୍ଟୱେୟାର ବେସ୍ଡ ଫାୟାରୱାଲ୍ସ ହାର୍ଡୱେୟାର ବେସ୍ଡ ଫାୟାରୱାଲ୍ସ ହାଉ ଟୁ ପ୍ରିଭେଣ୍ଟ ୟର ନେଟୱାର୍କ ଫ୍ରମ୍ ଆନୋନାଇମସ୍ ଆଟାକ୍ କନଫିଗୁରିଂ ଫାୟାରୱାଲ୍ ଇନ୍ ୟର କମ୍ପ୍ୟୁଟର ବହୁତ ସୁନ୍ଦର ଭାବରେ ଡିସ୍କସନ୍ କଲେ ତ ମେନି ଥ୍ୟାଙ୍କ୍ସ ଟୁ ଅଲ୍ ଆଜିର କନକ୍ଲୁଜନ ଟିକୁ ଏଠି ଆମେ ରଖୁଛୁ
ସମସ୍ତ ସମସ୍ତ ଲର୍ଣ୍ଣରକୁ ପୁଣି ରିକ୍ୱେଷ୍ଟ କରାଉଛି ଯାହା ଯେତେବେଳେ ଦରକାର ମୋ ଟେଲିଫୋନ୍ ନମ୍ବର ଆପଣ ତାଙ୍କୁ ଦେଇ ଦିଅନ୍ତୁ ଚାହିଁବେ ଫୋନ କରନ୍ତୁ, ଆଇ ଏମ୍ ରେଡିଲି ଆଭେଲେବଲ ଟୁ ଡିସ୍କସ୍, ଆଇ ଏମ୍ ଭେରି ଫ୍ରେଣ୍ଡଲି, ମତେ ଜାଣିବେ ରିଏଲି ଆଇ ଏମ୍ ଭେରି ଫ୍ରେଣ୍ଡଲି ଆଣ୍ଡ ଲୋ ପ୍ରୋଫାଇଲ ପର୍ସନ କହିବା କଥା ନୁହଁ, ମାଇ ସେଲ୍ଫ ଇଜ୍ 101% ଲୋ ପ୍ରୋଫାଇଲ ପର୍ସନ, ଏନିୱାନ୍ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ଅଲ୍ସୋ କଣ୍ଟାକ୍ଟ ଟୁ ମି ଆଟ୍ ଏନି ଟାଇମ୍, ଦି ଲର୍ଣ୍ଣର୍ସ ଲର୍ଣ୍ଣର୍ସ ଆର୍ ହାଇଲି ୱେଲକମ୍ଡ, ଦେ ଆର୍ ରିଏଲି ଆୱାର ଏସେଟ୍, ଏସେଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ ଆୱାର ଲର୍ଣ୍ଣର୍ସ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଓଏସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ ରାଇଟ୍ ପ୍ଲାଟଫର୍ମ, ଦି ଲର୍ଣ୍ଣର୍ସ ଆର୍ ଚୁଜନ୍, ସୋ ଦାଟ୍ ୱି ଫାଷ୍ଟ ୱି ଆର୍ ନଟ୍ ବଟ୍ ୱି ଆର୍ ନଟ୍ ସଜେଷ୍ଟିଂ, ୱି ଆର୍ କୋପରେଟିଭ୍ଲି ଆଣ୍ଡ ଫ୍ରେଣ୍ଡଲି ଡିସ୍କସିଂ ବିଥ୍ ଦେମ୍ ଏଜ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଭେନ୍ ଦେ ଆର୍ ରିକ୍ୱାର୍ଡ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଏନଦର ଥିଙ୍ଗ ଅଲ୍ ଦି ଓଏସ୍ ୟୁ ଷ୍ଟାଫ୍ସ ଦେ ଆର୍ ଅଲ୍ସୋ invited to me to give deliver my talk, it is a nice opportunity to me and highly thankful to the DC sir and okay. also all the staffs and my sincere thanks and my hearty thanks to all the staffs of the OSU. Thank you sir.
Thank you sir. Thank you. Thank you.
Namaskar sir. Rai. ସାର୍ କେମିତି ଲାଗିଲା, ଭଲ ଲାଗିଲା ସାର୍ ଆଜିର କ୍ଲାସଟା, କେମିତି ଲାଗିଲା ସାର୍?
ହଁ ସାର୍ ଭଲ ଲାଗିଲା ସାର୍,
ଭଲ ଲାଗିଲା, ହଉ ଥ୍ୟାଙ୍କ ୟୁ. ଆପଣ ଗୁଡ୍ ନେମ୍ ସାର୍?
ଅମିତ ତ୍ରିପାଠୀ ସାର୍.
ହଉ ସାର୍, ଆଉ ଥରେ ପୁଣି ସାକ୍ଷାତ ହେବା, ରହିଲି, ହଉ.
ୟେସ୍ ସାର୍, ଥ୍ୟାଙ୍କ ୟୁ. ନମସ୍କାର ସାର୍.
ନମସ୍କାର ନମସ୍କାର,
ବହୁତ 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 ବଢିଆ ଲାଗିଲା ସାର୍,
ବହୁତ ବଢିଆ ଲାଗିଲା. ହଉ ଥ୍ୟାଙ୍କ ୟୁ, ଥ୍ୟାଙ୍କ ୟୁ. ଆପଣ ଦେଇଥିଲେ ମୁଁ ଦେଖିଲି, ଆପଣ ଅଡିବୁଲ ହଉଥିଲେ, ଶୁଣୁଥିଲେ ଆପଣ
ସାର୍? ସାର୍
ଆଗରୁ କେବେ ଆମକୁ ଦେଖା ହେଇଥିଲେ ନା ନାହିଁ? ଆଜି ଫାର୍ଷ୍ଟ ଟାଇମ୍ ସାକ୍ଷାତ?
ନା ସାର୍, ଫାର୍ଷ୍ଟ ଟାଇମ୍ ସାକ୍ଷାତ ସାର୍.
ସାକ୍ଷାତ, କ୍ଲାସଟା କେମିତି ଲାଗିଲା?
ବହୁତ ବଢିଆ ଲାଗିଲା ସାର୍,
ବହୁତ ବଢିଆ ଲାଗିଲା. କିଛି କିଛି ନୂଆ କଥା ଜାଣିବାକୁ ମିଳିଲା?
ହଁ, ଜାଣିବାକୁ ମିଳିଲା ସାର୍.
ହଉ ଥ୍ୟାଙ୍କ ୟୁ, ଥ୍ୟାଙ୍କ ୟୁ ସାର୍. କ୍ଲୋଜ୍ କରିଦେବା, କ୍ଲୋଜ୍ କରିଦେବା ନା
ସାର୍? ସାର୍ ସାର୍,
ହଉ ଥ୍ୟାଙ୍କ ୟୁ ସାର୍.
ଆଜ୍ଞା ନମସ୍କାର ସାର୍.
ନମସ୍କାର.